Thank you. Oh! My name is Tony Colombo. I am the co-host of the Dave Glover Show on FM News Talk 97.1. Our show's on every day at 3 o'clock, every weekday at 3 o'clock. On behalf of myself and my show and our radio station, I just want to say thanks for having us out here today. Thanks for having me out here today. It's an honor to be here with you guys. It's an honor to be a part of this celebration of our veterans. So just want to welcome everyone to the 2016 Florissant's Veterans Day Parade and Celebration, honoring the men and women who have and continue to serve the greatest military on the planet, the United States military. We are going to get today's festivities started with a singing of God Bless America. Please welcome Kathy Wilson.
Please sing along.
God bless America, land that I love. Stand beside her and guide her through the night with the light from above, from the mountains to the to the oceans white with foam. God bless America, my home, sweet home.
Big round of applause for Kathy Wilson. That was beautiful. They would like us to, and I would be honored to lead everyone, if you would stand up again for just 1 second, lead everyone in the saying of the Pledge of Allegiance. So let's all do it together, okay?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God,
and now I'd like to introduce Pastor Pastor Orville Mueller of the Chapel of the Cross as he delivers the invocation.
Heavenly Father, your Son taught us that greater love has no one than to lay down his life for his brother or sister. Today, this parade just concluded has given honor to those men and women who have laid their lives on the line to protect our country from those enemies that seek our country's harm. We especially praise you for the courage of the many hundreds of thousands who lost their lives in the battles of previous wars and current wars. We praise you for the sacrifice of the many hundreds of thousands who came home or who are coming home with missing limbs or sight or hearing or other major lifelong damage. Give them determination to go on living productive lives. We praise you for the sacrifice of the many thousands who came home or who are coming home with emotional trauma that incapacitates them as loving spouses or parents. Give them healing, O Lord. We praise you for the sacrifice of all the veterans who are courageously willing to risk life and limb to protect our freedoms and our lives. And we are bold to pray for the safety of all of our service personnel, government leaders, policemen and firemen, and all other first responders. We give you praise and make our request in the name of Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord. Amen.
Yeah, that always makes us feel better. I like the yays. That's pretty good. Guys, we're here today to honor our heroes, to remember their achievements, their courage, and their dedication, and to say thank you for their sacrifices. Thinking of the heroes who join us in this group today and those who are here only in spirit, A person can't help but feel awed by the enormity of what we encounter. We stand in the midst of patriots and the family and friends of those who have nobly served. I'd like to ask these service members and veterans who are here today to please stand up so we can properly thank you. Thank you for answering the call of duty. You've made our armed forces the most respected in the world. I'd also like to thank the St. Louis County Veterans Coalition for making this event possible. Thank you. Thanks to Ken Hoffman, who's here. He's the commander of the Korean War veterans. And now I would like to introduce a gentleman who would like to come up and say a few words on this beautiful day. Florissant Mayor Tom Schneider. Mr. Mayor.
Thank you, Tony, and thank you for agreeing to come to the beautiful city of Florissant to MC this event, this important event for a very patriotic, faith-based community of Florissant. The historic community of Florissant goes back to the days of the founding of our country. We're actually a couple years older than the Constitution of the United States, and if you go out to Coldwater Cemetery or St. Ferdinand Cemetery, so the historic cemeteries in our area, you will see veterans from every conflict going all the way back to the Revolution, including the Revolution. Think about that. People have been in this valley that fought in the Revolutionary War and all the conflicts in between until today. I'm so proud of all the first responders that are here. We have our police department here that's headed by Major Fagan. Chief Lowry had to be out of town on business. Our police department, let's give them a round of applause. The Florissant Valley Fire Protection District serves us, protects us, and also helps us to make feel safe in the Blackjack Fire District. Let's give them a round of applause. And all the other jurisdictions that serve us, we appreciate them as well. We are in Ward 6, and it was mandatory that all members that were ever elected to serve as a council member from Ward 6 are here today. We have Bob Garrett and his wife, Tony. Dan Sullivan was here. We also have Pat Stinnett, our parade marshal. And we have our current councilman, Gerard Henke. We also have from, in the parade we had, and I think they're still here, Tim Lee from Ward 1, and then Tim Jones from Ward 2, Joe Egan from Ward 3, a fellow veteran, Marine Corps veteran, Jeff Caputa from Ward 4, Keith Shildroth from Ward 5, and I already mentioned Councilman Henke, and then from Ward 7, our council president, Jackie Pagano, and Ward 8, Mark Schmidt, and Ward 9, Tommy Siam. Also from the city of Hazelwood, we have Matt Robinson is here. Yay! And I believe Gretchen Bangert was in the parade. I don't know if she's here. Did I miss any state reps or county officials? We also have the president of the Chamber of Commerce here, Judy Taylor. She just took over this year. And we have the veterans groups, we have the VFW and American Legion and every veterans group, the Vietnam veterans, the Korean veterans, everybody's here today to, and also the auxiliaries are here to honor this occasion. So without further ado, I'm going to turn this back over to our MC. Just thank everybody for coming out, and just an honor to be the mayor of such a patriotic, faith-based community. Thank you. Yay!
Today it's our privilege to say thank you to all of America's veterans, to let them know that we appreciate them for their service and honor them for their sacrifices. The price of freedom is high. We cannot afford to forget those willing to pay for it. Right now I'd like to salute Florissant's 2015 Veteran of the Year and this year's Parade Marshal, Pat Stinnett. Pat served in the United States Air Force during the Vietnam War and has continued to serve in military and civilian roles throughout his career. Please welcome with a big round of applause, Pat Stinnett.
Thank you. Well, thank you very much this afternoon. It's certainly a thrill to see so many folks come out on such a fine day to honor the people that have served this great nation. When I stand here as the Veteran of the Year, it's not a personal award by any means. I stand here to represent what has been published here lately as the 7% of our population that has put on a uniform to serve our country. So I'd like to take just a minute and give one last round of applause to that 7%. I'm going to put a little plug in at this point in time for the VFW, for the American Legion, for the Vietnam Veterans of America. We hear many times of their organizations, and I think a lot of us wonder just what they do. I think probably at the parade today you saw coming along the route a group that they call Cooties that were taking up money. These gentlemen do nothing but work for hospitalized veterans. That's all they do. They provide the resources that they need. Your VFW and your American Legion, while they all are both organizations run many different functions, the dollars that they collect are for nothing but be turned back into the community. Somewhere in the neighborhood of about 60% of their revenues go back to the community, so they should be honored for that. Thank you. Yeah. And last but not least, I want to take just a minute. You know, the St. Louis County Veterans Coalition is the group that meets annually. They meet monthly, I should say, to run different programs and to elect a Veteran of the Year. And one of the things that you learn you should never do is name anyone an organization, because once you name one, you leave somebody else off, which always causes a problem. But I did want to recognize Walt Kaiser. I'm sure everybody knows Walter. There's been rumors that Walter organized his first parade just right after the Civil War. So he has been around for a while. And then he brought on his buddy Carl Hargis, and Carl couldn't be with us, but I think Carl was a veteran of the Spanish-American War, I think. So they've been well represented. But no, on a serious note, I do want to thank the St. Louis County Veterans Coalition, the VFW, the American Legion, the Vietnam Veterans, the Korean War Veterans, and I know I'll miss someone, and last but not least, all the citizens that come out here to honor. Thank you very much.
Right now I want to introduce today's guest speaker, Frank Mantilla. Served in the United States Army, Frank began his military career in October of 1970, serving in the Army prior to retiring from active duty in May of 2000. His last assignment was serving as a CSM for the Space and Missile Defense Command from February 1998 to March of 2000. Frank proudly served his country and was awarded numerous awards and decorations, which included the Distinguished Service Medal, the Bronze Star Medal, and the Emeritus Service Medal. Frank is now completely retired. It says completely, like, in all caps here. Completely retired, and spends his time volunteering with the USO of Missouri and is the chairperson for the Gateway Chapter 82nd Airborne Association. Please join us and myself in a warm welcome to United States Army retired Frank Mantilla.
Thanks very much. What I'd like to do first is thanks the city of Florissant for having this great parade. This is the third year that the 82nd Association has been in this parade. We really enjoy it. It gives a real hometown atmosphere. It's a lot better than the parade downtown in St. Louis. Tell you right off the top, a lot more people show up for this parade than ever show up for the parade downtown St. Louis. And we veterans, I know all of us appreciate what you do here. I grew up in North County. I'm a North County kid, and patriotism just overwhelms you in this part of the St. Louis area. What I want to talk a little bit about is sacrifice. I spent 30 years in the Army, and my story is not unusual. is for anyone that made themselves a career soldier, and those that didn't have all sacrificed. Whether you were drafted like I was in 1970, and then 30 years later I got out, or you stayed in 2 years, 3 years, 4 years, whatever it was. You made a sacrifice by coming in to the service, whatever that service was, whether it be the Army, Navy, Marine Corps, Air Force, or Coast Guard. You made some type of sacrifice to come into the service. You left your family behind. You left your loved ones behind. Myself, I left my wife and my 30-day-old child behind when I went in. And from there on, while I was in the service, many more sacrifices, not only by me, but by my family. On no-notice deployments, went to Grenada, got a call one night, left home. I was in the 82nd Airborne Division. 2 months later, I came home. Desert Storm, I was a battalion command sergeant major in the 82nd Airborne Division. Got a call at 2 o'clock in the morning. My wife and I had just got back to the 82nd from deployment to Germany overseas for 3 years. We were only there for about a week. Our household goods were delivered that day. I gave her a kiss goodbye. She says, where are you going? I said, listen to the news. 9 months later, I came home. Them are the type of sacrifices that not only me, but soldiers, airmen, sailors all make on a daily basis. On a daily basis. Soldiers we have deployed now, they may not have got a non-notice, but they're over there in the Army, they're over there for a year. Right now we have 1,700 paratroopers from the 82nd Airborne Division deploying back to Iraq to fight ISIS and Mosul. I bet most of you didn't know that, because it's not headlines anymore. We had 6 Special Forces soldiers die in the past 2 weeks. 3 in Jordan, 2 in Afghanistan, and 1 in training down in Florida. That happens all the time. We lose soldiers, we lose sailors, we lose airmen and Marines, and nothing's ever said about it in the paper. All right? So you have to keep your ear to that stuff, and when you see a vet, thank that vet. Thank that vet. There's one story of sacrifice. There's one story of sacrifice I'd like to share with you. It's a personal story of someone I knew when he was just a little kid. His name was Jimmy Patton. His father was one of my NCOs in the 82nd Airborne Division during Desert Storm. I sort of took his father under my wing and mentored him, as you do, went up through the ranks. When I always knew, when Jimmy was a little baby, when my daughters were babysitting him, that one day he was going to be a soldier. He just loved playing soldier and being in soldier uniforms. Well, his dad was a command sergeant major in the 101st Airborne Division. He was deployed to Afghanistan. Jimmy was now 23 years old, had a wife, had a daughter that was 2 months old. He went back for his 4th deployment to Iraq. Now, the Rangers go over there 3 to 6 months at a time because they are op tempos so much. Well, he was on a mission on a helicopter flying in to get some high Al-Qaeda terrorists. On that mission, Jimmy was killed. Jimmy was killed. That's not the end of the story, though. His father was deployed to Afghanistan during that time with the 101st Airborne Division. His father was called in Afghanistan, told that his son had just died in Iraq. He flew from Afghanistan to Iraq, escorted his son's body home. After his son was buried at Arlington Cemetery, he went back home with his wife for 2 weeks, and because he still had soldiers in harm's way, he flew back over there with them soldiers. Now, that leaves his wife alone. Luckily, she has 2 other children who are with her to help her through that time. But that's the kind of sacrifices that military families in military make on an everyday basis. and we can't forget that. One thing I'd like to read to you. One of my friends here have been taking a lot of beating lately, if I can hold everything down here. Good friend of all of ours, all right? I am your flag. I am the flag of the United States of America. I am called O Glory. I am called the Star-Spangled Banner. I am the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air. I am the eminence of patriotism. I am the trenches in France, Belgium, Anzio, Normandy, Omaha Beach, Guadalcanal, and Korea. I am the jungles of Vietnam, and the sands of Desert Storm, and the streets of Bosnia, Afghanistan, and Iraq. I am one nation under God. I am the names of those who never came back to keep this republic free. When you salute me, you are actually saluting them. I am the symbol of America, the home of the proud, the brave, and the free. Don't ever forget that about your flag. Again, I'd like to thank the city of Florissant, all the veterans, VFW Post, Dave Miller for inviting me here. I hate thanking Dave for anything. And those of you that know Dave know what I'm talking about. We call him Papa Smurf at the USO. And one other group I'd like to thank are our police officers who put it on the line for us every day. Put us on the line for us every day. Remember that when I drive out in my blue Mustang with the top down, okay? Again, thanks again. Thank the city of Florissant, and God bless America.
Thank you. Tony, there is one group I want to recognize. We have our Valley of Flowers Queen and her court, and I'd like to recognize them and everybody who's 20 or younger that's here today, because you're the future of this great nation, and we salute you also.
All right. Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Powerful stuff from Frank. One more big round of applause for Frank Mantilla. Frank made a great point that I wanted to just tell you a quick story about the parade that we had here today. And Frank mentioned the parade that's downtown. My radio station has been a part of Veterans Day parades for the last 10 years or so. And we are located in downtown St. Louis, so for years we were a part of the city parade. And it was an honor to do that, and it was something we were proud to do, but it was a little bit depressing to go down empty streets in this parade and, you know, only see one or two pockets of people there. I know we had a beautiful day today, but we also had great turnout, and that just speaks to the community. The mayor was talking about that a few minutes ago. I'm born and raised in Florissant Hazelwood area, proud to call this my home, and it was just really cool to see the turnout that we had here tonight as opposed to what we've seen at other parades in the past. So that's for... My daughter Maggie, my youngest daughter, is sitting right there on the steps. She's 6 years old. She got a chance to, she was selected as one of just a handful of people. Look how interested she is in Daddy talking right now. Maggie. Hi. She's like, I'm playing my game. Leave me alone. She was selected, she goes to Russell Elementary, and she was selected as one of just a handful of people to go up on stage. They had a thing at school this week where a couple of veterans came and spoke to the school, and she got selected to go on stage and shake a veteran's hand and thank them for their service. And so I asked her the day before she was doing, her and I were practicing in the living room shaking hands. So she was, and I asked her, without any explanation or anything, I said, Maggie, what is a veteran? And she said, a veteran is a person who leaves their family to go to a very dangerous place and fight bad guys. And I thought that was the best description you could hear about somebody from the military. So that was really cool.
Go Maggie.
Yeah, that's right. Go Maggie.
Go Maggie.
She's like, Dad, I just want to go to McDonald's. Can we move this along? All right. Back on track. Gives me great pleasure to introduce this year's winner of the award for the 2016 Florissant Veteran of the Year. Frank Demos will be up here in just a second. Frank began his military career in the United States Army in 1965. He completed his basic and advanced individual training at Fort Leonard Wood. In July of 1967, he was assigned to the 173rd Airborne Brigade in Vietnam, where he saw combat. After leaving the military, Frank moved to Florissant in 1985 with his family, realizing the need for a VVA chapter. And with the help of another Vietnam vet, in 1995, the VVA Chapter 794 was established. Frank has served as president several times, and in his first term, he and the members of the VVA chapter added to the Vietnam War Memorial Monument at Coke Park more names of soldiers killed in Vietnam from the Florissant-Hazelwood area. In 2003, Frank was president again, and the VVA Chapter 794 was instrumental in bringing the Vietnam Moving Wall to Florissant. So, along with 2015 Florissant Veteran of the Year Award, Pat Stennett, we'd like to give a round of applause and welcome up the 2016 Florissant Veteran of the Year, Frank Demos. Come on up.
Thank you, Tony. You don't look anything like I imagined you from listening to the radio.
I got a face for radio, that's for sure.
I didn't say that. This is nice. Yeah. Very nice. Yeah. You're going to hear some more familiar names. When Walt Kaiser came over to my house and told me that I had been selected, I said, "You guys are scraping the bottom of the barrel. Really?" And then Dave Miller congratulated me and told me I had to make a 45-minute speech. Don't worry, I'm not going to do that.
Four and a half minutes.
He left the decimal point out. I'm really humbled and I'm really honored that I was chosen or selected for this award. Florissant's been my hometown now for more than 30 years. It's a great place to live, a great place to raise a family. On this day, I've got all four of my kids together for the first time in a long time. Most of my grandchildren and two of my great-grandchildren. Again, I'm really humbled. I'm proud to look out and see so many friends. Pat talked a little bit earlier about all the VSO, the Veteran Service Organizations, and I want to remind all the veterans, if you haven't done so, find a Veteran Service Organization, the VFW, the American Legion, whatever, and join. A lot of times, you might have saw it on the news, that a lot of times the veterans have trouble protecting their benefits. These veteran service organizations are the ones that will help keep our benefits. Pat also said that 7% of Americans are veterans, which is a low number, but an even lower number is the United States is guarded now by less than 1%. The military makes up less than 1% of the total population. So if you haven't joined a VSO, find one and join. And the last thing I've got to say is thank God for this beautiful day. God bless Florissant, and God bless the United States of America. Thank you.
We're a little bit out of sequence here, but we're going to get this thing done right yet. In the world, we're going to get this thing open. There we go. We're going to get dope here in just a minute. I have to make a couple of comments. I can never get away from it if I don't do it. You know, people keep hearing about the name Dave Miller. Well, Dave and Frank and I and a number of other people, we volunteer at the USO at the airport. And I think any of them will tell you that's one of the more enjoyable experiences we have. It's quite fun to aggravate the young troops. You know, you could just imagine that many days there's 300 to 400 young troops going through there a day on their way to Fort Leonard with the basic training. And their eyes are about that big around. And I think probably on most days their mothers wouldn't be happy with what we say to them. But they do enjoy it. About 12 weeks later, they get a kick out of it. One last thing before I get to Frank, I want to say this about Dave Miller. I talked about Walter and the Civil War and all that. Well, Dave was in the Navy. And when Dave went in the Navy, they still had boats, wooden boats, and they had guys that roll them, okay? Dave's first job was to beat the drum for the rhythm in the back. Dave had no rhythm. They ended up firing him. They couldn't do it. But anyway, Dave, we appreciate your service. But let's get to Frank. On a very serious note, I wanted to read this. Frank. Frank has put many long hours in the community working for the veterans, working for the community itself. This is an honor that is well deserved. Fact is, I was taken back that he hadn't received this award up to this point. So I think it's with great honor that I stand here, and I want to read this to you. It says, presented to John Frank Demos, 2016 Florissant Veteran of the Year. And Frank, I say congratulations. Well deserved.
Thank you, Pat. Thank you.
I'm just getting ready to come back up here and say my goodbyes and thank everybody once again, and particularly Frank and Pat. And as I'm walking up the steps, Maggie says, I gotta go potty. So I'll keep this last part really quick because somebody's got to go potty. This concludes our presentation. We want to invite you guys to stay here at VFW Post 4105, listen to music, join us as we honor all of our veterans, especially our brand new 2016 Veteran of the Year. Want to say thank you to Domino's, Papa John's, Shomi's, Hooters, and Honey Baked Ham for providing lunch today. And one last time, on behalf of myself, my radio station, I am so proud. You can go. Go ahead. So proud to, thank you. So proud to be a part of this today. And so proud to be up here with these great men who have served. The pastor, the mayor, and so honored to be here in front of all of you guys today. So one last time, big round of applause for everyone. Thank you for attending today. God bless you. God bless your family. God bless our troops. And God bless America, everybody. Have a great day.